Bingo. A green tea, organic green tea for the game guys out there. As the recording starts up. At least I can see the stream, that's good. So good once it hits the lips. Ooh-wee. Welcome back in, everybody. It's the live stream Let's Play. MLB The Show 16, as we're following the road to the show career of one Derek Metzger. You already saw the pinstripes, you know what's going on. Once we last left you, we just got into the month of June, which is where we kind of picked things up. Former team. Well, the team I used to be on, the Baltimore Orioles. We are home for this one, Yankee Stadium. That'll two games back in the division behind these damn or do they even call them the Orange Bird? They call them the O's, I know. The O-Bird, maybe? I don't know. Fuck it, we gotta play. Let me get you the 3-game minimum for recording. So, fired up really soon. LeMahieu, Castro, Kike Hernandez, they got some good batting average. Look. Maybe for the Orioles and the Giants. The Marlins, I don't know. They throw that little bit of yellow in there, that little bit of powder, baby blue, whatever you want to call it. Oh, by the way, I won the Cy Young last year. Don't know if too many people know that. In case you haven't followed this career at all. Whether you're watching here live on Twitch or you're watching episodically on YouTube at your own leisure, I do thank you either way you're watching. Whether it's on a PC or a Mac, an iPhone, an Android, a tablet, on a PS4, on an XB1. Don't matter to me. As long as you're watching and you enjoy it. Oh, that was the trade. Metzger for Castro. That's how we both ended up where we are. Straight up trade. It still bothers me, though. Now, granted, I have a World Series win under my belt here with the pinstripes. But Baltimore's on the uprise right now. And for how good this Yankees team should be. We're not that good. We're not performing to where we should be. I don't think. DJ fucking LeMahieu. Well, that was in there.
First pitch, 706.
Kind of went for it. It landed either way. Okay. Hey, a two-pitch out. I'll
In
take
the
that all
second
game.
spot tonight.
Even
Second
if it means
baseman,
zero fucking strikeouts. I mean,
Castro.
come on, I'm out of here in what, 54 pitches that'd be? 47, yeah, something like that. 27 outs, yeah. Let's just give some leeway. 60 pitches, right?
Follow that
Ooh,
down for
just outside. I mean, it kind of hit the zone, but no, that's one of those weird things that I'll think of kind of as I'm playing this. And maybe I've asked it before. Damn, good shot past the line. But I wonder what, for a starting pitcher, complete game, let's
Batting
say,
third,
the
center
fewest
fielder,
pitches he threw
Kike
to
Hernandez.
get through said ball game.
Aye.
Slider right down the middle. Thankfully, he was looking. Thankfully, he was still looking. Oh, little pull shot, damn it. And all of a sudden, when guys on first and second, well, there goes my 60 pitch
Batting
idea.
fourth, the left fielder, number 10,
I should already be in the second
Adam
inning right now.
Chung.
7 is be 8 pitches.
Aye.
Bam.
All ones the count.
Whoop. There we go. Double play that shit.
Out.
Spinaroonie. Got
Got
him.
it.
Got him, got him, got him. Double play ball to get us out of the yam. The yam, the jam. Well, they start off with two fucking hits. Some teams, they'll just start attacking you. I don't know. They got a couple on me, but let's speed through our three-game minimum here. Let's rough up Tanaka, can we? No, we cannot. Okay.
Leading off for Baltimore.
Come on, Cairo.
Right fielder, Alex Cairo.
Ball.
Oh, come on, ump.
Ball one, no strike.
That's good enough. Joe McDonald is the ump, sitting behind home plate. Yep. Got to give a song to it. I'm pretty sure I did that the last time I saw this cat. Oh, shit.
Ball, that's outside.
Bad timing. Totally cloudy here at Yankee Stadium.
Hey.
Maybe some bad weather will creep in. I don't recall if that ever happens. Like, when there is rain, the rain does vary through the game. Sometimes it comes down a little heavier. You can't quite notice it here on the stream, on the recording, whatever. It's a little tough to see. But I don't recall a game where it started out nice. Damn. And then clouds rolled in and then rain started to come along, or it started really shitty and then the, you know, sky just parted. Booyah. Screwball. Punching him out.
Batting six, the first baseman, number 34, Christian Walker.
All right, Walker, what do you got, huh? Other than one out, what else you got here, huh, kid? You're not Todd Walker. You're not Larry Walker.
0-2 is the count.
And I'm thankful for all of that. Another screwball. And he'll go. Have yourself a seat there, Charlie. Why Charlie, I don't know. The screwball is Uncle Curly, so I don't know. I mean, I gave it that nickname. Does the screwball have like a weird, you know... I don't know how the fucking curveball got the nickname Uncle Charlie. Unless there was a pitcher named Charlie back in the day who was really proficient at throwing the damn thing. Oh, nice. A little basket catch right there by Perez. And we're out of the inning. Friedrich, Parker, and Santana. Friedrich ain't too bad. Well, I say that. He was a trade that we got from the Marlins. I think that was last season. Nothing doing there, so we move on. Shit. Some games I don't mind when we move along too quick, you know, just if we have a lead always helps.
Kareem Higgins.
Because if the opposition gets their usual, you know, one or two solo shots in the game, well... And the game flying by too quick can always be problematic. Hey, control, you just... Trying to... Very weird. Somewhere down here, I think. Not that it went there, but I tried.
Two balls, two strikes.
That you can see how it's like. Why the fuck? Come on here. Maybe the laptop. No, but I'm hardwired in. It's no wonder, or no longer a worry about. Maybe my wireless controller is too close to my wireless laptop. Screwball. And he'll sit down.
Batting ninth, third baseman, Pablo Ruiz.
I mean, with those numbers, you can't even tell, like, home or road, what's better, because the home runs are too close, the RBIs are too close. I mean, that batting average could be an absolute fluke.
Hey.
And see this, good. He's a really bad down-and-away hitter. Let's keep attacking that. My pitches are generally drop pitches. Well, I was just...
On two.
He was chasing. Wrong pitch. But he wanted it down and away, which is good. Okay, same thing, just screwball. And I'm okay with that. Indeed, I am.
The batter, number nine.
Motherfucking LeMahieu.
DJ LeMahieu.
Hey!
Watch that first pitch go by, see what you're dealing with. Now here comes the party.
The count, 0-2.
Looked like a safety swing, just a little, let me try to push it.
Ball Oof, way.
Good eye. I'll give you that, kid. Ah. To the track, and that's all it'll go. Good. I swear it sounds like SportsCenter. There we go, Herrera. Strikeout, pop up. There's a hit, and nothing there. Well, damn.
Leading off for the Orioles, second baseman, Starlin Castro.
Terrible placement here, come on. I mean, yeah, he took it for a strike, but that's just my benefit.
No balls, two strikes.
Over the top of that one. Push that thing a little away. Went for it. Got that extended out there reach. Too bad on three pitches, kid. Too bad. Too fucking bad, right? I would just think with the drop of these pitches, you'd see a lot of guys trying to get uppercut swing to it. Maybe that slider would catch him more. Oh, good pull, but a good snag.
He's out.
Nicely done.
The left fielder, number 10, Adam Jones.
Those are sharp uniforms. I like that black and orange, man. That's got a mean look to it. I like that. Giants, same thing. They don't try to overdo it. Marlins. With a little bit of yellow and a little bit of blue. No, just black and orange. Maybe there's a little bit of white trim to accentuate a few things.
Yeah.
But it ain't nothing all that fancy. Certain uniforms, I just like them better than others. Whiff on the sweeper. I mean, I like the pinstripe of the Yankees. I mean, the logo itself, the hat logo ain't nothing. I don't mind, like, the Uncle Sam top hat with the bat and all that stuff. That's kind of cool. Yeah, like that guy's shirt. Like, that's kind of a cool logo. But that's, you know, kind of, that might be a shoulder patch logo. They don't use that, you know, on the jersey, on the chest, or on the hat itself. I don't think. Maybe they have in the past, but perhaps an alternate uniform.
Leading off for Baltimore.
But otherwise, just that NY. And that's classic. That's, you know, it's nothing flashy. Like, I know I've kind of gone, you know, with the Twins logos. I like that TC, or that M. That capital red N with that little, not quite a Nike swoosh underneath it, but, you know, that thing. That always worked for me. The old Mariners look, where it was like a trident. The M for Mariners. I kind of like that old looking, you know, back in the day. The Harold Reynolds look. Kind of like that Mariners logo. The Astros logo that they got now, which goes retro back to, like, you know, the 80s. I like that. It's kind of... Sure, it's got all that orange and yellow and shit to it. Looks really space age. What with the Astrodome, right? That kind of works for me, though. I like that. Texas Rangers, too plain for me. I don't dig that. The Mets. I like Mr. Met. They could use that little alternate logo thing a little bit more. Kind of like the Cincinnati Reds got their little mustachioed baseball face guy. Otherwise, just that tapered C like the Chicago Bears have. I mean, it's fair. No, it's nothing fancy. And that's just a red and a white uniform.
The batter, number 13.
That I believe was a sweeper, if I saw it right.
Danny Espinosa.
Da-na-na, da-na-na. You know, and as I do like the Cleveland Indians logo, Old Chief Wahoo. I like it, but it's terribly... It is. It's racially offensive. I think they could do something a little better with that. Look at him on the... Oof, I was going to say he kept running and running. I like when they stand there and look up. I mean, the Chief Wahoo thing, they could make that thing look better. It has a cartoonish look, but yeah, it's, you know... The older I've gotten, the more like, okay, yeah, that's just a little... That's too much. You know what I mean? Well, the Atlanta Braves, and I've met Freddie Baez, two-run homer, thank you. But the Atlanta Braves used to have an old logo. It was kind of like a screaming Indian face, and he had a couple feathers up in the headdress type thing. Like that. And that just kind of looked like a drawn face. It wasn't so overly cartoonish and, I don't know, maybe... stereotypical, if you want to say that, of Chief Wahoo. But I think you could get a new look Chief Wahoo and not have it be so... It just look... Okay, like, picture it this way. The Washington NFL team, right? Now, the look on that helmet, and again, I don't even want to say that name because when you think about it, that sounds pretty offensive. But the Washington NFL helmet, that logo... That's a decent logo. I like it. It's just it's got the face of what or a profile, excuse me, of I don't know if that's a cheap or anything like that or oh shit. But he's under it. I mean, I don't know if that's supposed to be a Indian cheap or whatever, but it just got the profile, little headdress and all that stuff. Nothing. It's just it looks like a picture of someone, you know? It doesn't look so Chief Wahoo, you know what I mean. You know what I mean. But I think the Indians could do something like that. See, now it's like, because of all that, they got that cursive capital I, or that just block letter C. Because Chief Wahoo, yeah, it's a little much. Like, I think you could still have something like that, but make it a little more, I guess, prideful, and not so negative and comedic, I guess. That's probably the better way to put it. Just my thought, because like I said, the Braves, the old one that they would use, like in the Dale Murphy days, and it was like an alternate logo. They've always kind of had that, like, that capital A. There was, like, thin, I don't know, like, not even stencil, but...
DJ LeMahieu.
But just that thin, taper-drawn kind of capital A for Atlanta. Maybe they have the little tomahawk... with that thing, who knows? But that screaming face of the Brave, that was, I don't remember ever hearing anything like, oh, that's a little offensive or whatever. The Kansas City Chiefs back in the day, going back to the NFL, their little logo, it was like a screwball. That was like a little Native American guy, like had the headdress run. He was running. I think he had like a hatchet or something. And like in the backdrop, it was kind of like all the states through the plains. Like I think like Missouri and Kansas and Oklahoma and all those states. It was kind of like, oh, okay, well that's, I don't know what tribe that'd be represented of geographically. But it's like, okay, a decent little logo. That's kind of focuses in on an area where possibly there was a big contingency of... natives. So, okay, nothing. I don't think there's anything wrong with that. But the old Chief Wahoo thing. And it's sad too because you take a movie like Major League. And it's like sadly, that was in what, late 80s, 88, 89 when they made that movie before all that the big talks of, you know what, that's kind of racially insensitive when you're looking at that logo. And they're right. But it's like, does that kind of scar the movie? I mean, I don't think so. But it's just, they could have easily been the Brewers and offend nobody. Because they did film that movie in Old County Stadium. They did not film the ballpark shots in Cleveland Municipal.
Ball, that's outside.
I don't know why that is, to tell you the truth. I don't know if they were working on building Jacobs Field, but no, I don't think they were. I think Jacob, or the original Municipal, not original, but old Cleveland Municipal, I think it was just a fucking dump. And that's why they didn't film there. Not to say that Milwaukee County Stadium was great, but I mean, well, they eventually got Miller Park, so there you go.
How about it? Left fielder, Adam Jones.
Two shutouts going from a third. We're in the seventh already. A couple of things I might want to adjust here. Moving forward. But what other logos do I kind of like? Well, like I said, some of the alternates, you know, Mr. Met, the mustachioed Cincinnati Reds, you know, that little, that figure with the baseball face, and he's got his old, like, 1890s mustache. Like, that's a cool one. It's really, and I guess that's where I kind of am with, like, Chief Wahoo. Like, it's kind of cartoonish, and, you know, it might attract the kids' eyes. And, I mean, you know, here in the States, baseball is the one sport that younger kids tend to gravitate to earlier for whatever reason. I can't say for whatever reason. When you're out of school, summer break, what is there? Baseball. You know, it's not hockey season. It's not basketball season. It's not even football season. What's on TV for a sport when you're out of school here in the summer? Baseball. I guess that's why it's the easier one to go with.
Safe.
He was in there. Two bad pitches. Hitting in the dirt. Oof, watching that one. But that was kind of what it was for me as a kid. Plus baseball cards.
I got to count one and two.
You know, I was loving those far more than basketball and football cards. Got right over the heart of the plate, but he fouls it away, thankfully. With the circle change. You know what? Swig of organic green tea.
Ladies and
for
gentlemen,
logo talk,
it's time
huh?
For the traditional seventh inning stretch.
Woo! Other logos I like. Or just, you know, uniforms, I guess. Hell, I don't know. There's not many that I would say are bad. There's just some like, they could use, maybe they're too much, maybe they're could use a little more. Sometimes, and I know I've said, like, I'm a Chicago guy. If it came down to it, I'm a Cubs guy. But until the White Sox and the Cubs play each other in a World Series, I don't care so long as the team wearing Chicago on the front of that jersey does well. I'm not going to fucking split hairs over it until it's a Subway Series. And only then would I say, like, okay, now I'm only going, you know, Cubs direction. If it came down to it. Otherwise, Chicago, I'm all for it. That's fine. Come on, stream. Starting to buffer, 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 buffer. Hate that. Bad timing, but I pushed it right to the shortstop.
Now batting, shortstop.
Seven complete, going for eight. You know, and it took me the longest time to figure out that the Milwaukee Brewers logo, you know, just that hand, that baseball mitt with the ball in the hand, it's a cartoon hand. It's a Simpsons hand. That's not four fingers and a thumb. It's three fingers and a thumb. And the shape of it, the fingers create an M, and the rest of the glove, because the B, this would be the middle, it creates an M. Like, there's your M, right? And then your thumb out here, B, or is it this way, this hand? Well, whatever it is. It shapes MB for Milwaukee Brewers. Took me the longest time to see that, and I was like, that's pretty fucking clever. But had no idea for years I mean, I had to be in my mid to late 20s when I first heard that and was like, you gotta be shitting me. It's like, yeah, look at it. It's a cartoon hand. It's a Simpsons hand. It's three fingers and a thumb, not four. I was like, holy shit. Never noticed it. Kind of like the Hartford Whalers logo. Like, I knew the whale tail. And, like, the big W that encompassed that, but somewhere in there, there's a gray H shape. For Hartford. Just double checking things on the text line. Need to let people know, like, nope, I gotta work early tomorrow, so I'm just chilling home, getting a couple, little bit of a recording done. And then that's it for me. Ninth inning here, 91 pitches in, that's good. So we will start, this will be pitch number 92, starting us off. I'm surprised they didn't just bring in Chapman with a two-run lead. I mean, I appreciate the fact that they're keeping me in because I like our chances better with me throwing than anybody else in the fucking league, but, you know. Oh, watching it for the sweeping curveball strikeout. Got to be greedy to some degree, right? Greedy to some degree. Yes, you heard me right. Well, if this is LeMahieu, who should be the leadoff guy, what does that mean? They got two hits on the day? I thought they had more, no? And not Justin Moore, no. I thought they had more, correct?
Mm. One ball, two strikes.
That slider's a little more, yeah, right around there. That's what I was thinking. The slider's a little more up now. Fuck. Still chased it. Slide, slide, slippity slide. When you're throwing sweeping curves and a sinker to stay alive. I don't know. Castro. It hasn't always been a fantastic voyage.
0-1.
Castro, you were traded straight up for the man you're facing now on the mound. He has a World Series, you do not.
Ball, that's outside.
But you're being very patient as I'm trying to bullshit my way through this at bat, striking your ass out to end the game.
That's ball three.
Son of a bitch, you know? Uh-oh. Full count. Freeze him. But I'm throwing the sinker. Because it's fast, there's not much movement, and I trust it. I've missed before on that frozen pitch. You've seen it. If you've watched my channel before, you know. Hey, got the complete game shutout. Very good. 18K. Eesh, I mean, that's a lot. That's right, I think I'm still on dynamic as part of the thing. When I put it on rookie, it's like they'll get like 7 hits and they'll get 3 runs and I don't get that. Like, I can't find the happy medium. I do want to make an adjustment on that, though, just to kind of get things in a better spot. Yeah, strikeouts all across except for the first inning. 2-2-2-2-2-3. Jesus Christ, all the way across. 3 shutouts in a season, 150 strikeouts in a season. Got the shutout, complete start, quality start, and a win. Unless I've been saying and repeating all that stuff. Oh, that's right, that started a drop. Velocity, but you know, control 93, okay, well, whatever, leave that. 5s and zeros, I guess. We can leave that. You know, let me check something here. I want to leave it on dynamic, I guess. Pitching, fielding, not presentation. Mode specific? No, it's where's sliders? That's what I want. Oh, here we go. Let me modify these to get everything. Oh boy, yeah. Cause see, now granted, when I had it on rookie, this would all stay the same. Just putting it to dynamic. See, even I don't want that much power, but hold on. So this is where I'll put all the computer shit here. Even though it's on dynamic. Computer manager hook. Adjust the threshold for a computer manager to pull pitchers off the mound. Shift to the right to pull pitchers sooner. Situation is still the dominant factor, and this option affects road to show pitchers as well. Yeah, I don't want to get pulled. I don't. Adjust the frequency of pickoffs by the computer pitcher. Impacts how often runners are attempted to be picked off in a game. Okay, yeah, I need to be a solid hitter. Got to. Apply modifications to my sliders now. Okay, would you like to save? Yes. So two games going here. Two games remaining, sorry. If we're going to do that three-game minimum thing that we likes to do, and you know I likes to do it. Anyway, you know what? Calendar. Let's get through this day. Nothing yet, okay. So we get the one we did. We won't get swept in this series. Severino, loss. Mueller, win. All right, so we gain one game on Baltimore. Fair. Day off. Two at Arizona. Loss. Loss. God damn it. Son of a bitch. Well, let's give this another whirl. Save first, though, right? Still on dynamic. I just kind of upped their sliders with a couple of things just to... Hopefully that balances out to some degree. Because I don't get with my ability. There's no shot that they should be doing what they sometimes do to me. Interactions. Now, I'm going to give this three tries. Kind of like usual. As soon as we find a deal... I don't think you're telling the truth. Load a game up. Load up. I don't believe them. I just don't. Couldn't find any potential trade partners. Motherfucker, if you can't dance with me... Like, come on. That's why I only took the $3 million as opposed to the $13 million they initially offered. Okay. Haven't reached a deal yet, but we're still looking for suitable trade opportunities. Can I, like, see our trading block? Just for fun. Because I really don't believe them. But okay, our interactions are done. We're about to play the White Sox. Let me save. So you know there ain't no bullshit. Like, I tried my three... In my three-game minimum here, I did my three attempts for a trade. And you know, if I can get this trade to happen, the first one that goes through is the one I'm going to take. I don't care if... Oh, and we're only two games back now, super. Like, I don't care if we end up... Well, the Orioles would be interesting because at 19th ranking, they're leading their division. If we go to the Rays, I don't care. That's just... I'll eat whatever. The Tigers are ranked 23rd and lead their division by two games. The White Sox are 20th. And they're only two games back of the leader. If we go to the Royals, ranked 26th. You know, who are the shit teams around here? Oh, the Phillies at 27th, they suck. The Braves at 28th, they suck. I would eat all of that. I would not care. The Reds at 21, the Brewers at 29. Cardinals at 14 and worse than their division. The Rockies at 30th. That would be interesting, though. They'd be pitching in Coors Field. That would be immensely interesting. We just lost two to the Diamondbacks, and they fucking suck. 25th, well, they beat the Yankees. Padres are 24th. Good defense and speed and pretty good power. I would help their pitching. See what I mean, though? How are we ranked second in the fucking league? My pitching, is it that good to this team? That, like, that really boosts us for? Because speed, contact, power... Nothing major. And how many teams win with great defense? Oh, they had a bunch of gold gloves out there. Okay, well, I guess that means the pitcher's getting hit a lot, right? Because I'd rather have good pitching than good defense, tell you the truth. Because good pitching means nobody's even making contact with the fucking ball. That's just my thought. Play that next appearance. And since we're on the road, let's go with the white brim, just for fun. Now, they get to wear the pinstripes, because they're home. And if they're the Chicago White Sox, why do they wear black socks? Right? These are the thoughts, right? You gotta ask those things. The Red Sox wear red socks, the White Sox wear black socks. I don't get that. Oh, yeah. Woo! Ah, organic green tea. 18 strikeouts the last start he had. Yeah, that's kind of... He's relentless. He's a kicker of many asses. Several. U.S. Cellular. Okay, we're 10 games above 500, but two back in our division. That's just, All right, look at those old. They're like Harold Baines jerseys from the 80s. Those are pretty sharp. I mean, granted, that's not the colors I picture the White Sox to be. That kind of red, white, and blue. Kind of Yankees colors, really. That's a good retro look. I dig those. Segura, not bad. Santana, not bad. Mariznick, but 333, how often do you play? Perez at 260, you're not bad for a catcher. I mean, those are almost ugly retro, but I still dig them. Oh, excuse me. Dallas Keuchel, remember, he's a modern day, he's a Houston Astro. Well, that's right, we're on the road, so the top of the first is gone. Look at this batting stance. Not a good pitch to start things off, but he didn't take it. Well, he took it, excuse me. He didn't take it for a ride. Okay, stream, if you're going to stay, like, locked up, I just can't have that. Oh! Got him. Woo! That was close, and how's my leg feel?
Batting second, right fielder, Douglas.
Oh, he's down. Am I out of the game? We got to reset here. Uh-oh. Stayed in, apparently. Okay, now this has me mildly concerned. What if at the end of the game it's like, yeah, that injury that you had is kind of fucking... It's got you hampered a little bit. And they're going to pull you out for a couple days. How would I do that? Well, maybe then this is a one-game recording, you know? Because I wouldn't want to go 9 innings here in... Comiskey slider. Just have to redo it if it says, dude, you're injured. Fuck off. You're done.
Batting third,
Adam Eaton. I like this cat.
Adam Eaton.
I don't know why, but I kind of picture him to be like a Paul Goldschmidt. Like, you're a really good batter that anybody would want, but you're on a team right now that's not seen as, you know, doing well. However, today with these retro unis, the Chicago White Sox are wearing red socks. I don't know. It's all right, Eaton. Take a seat. Look at them sexy shoes. Some black, some navy on there, some white. And that's another thing, too. Like, when I switch teams, like... Gonna have to placate a little bit to the team colors and do all that stuff. With the batting gloves. Maybe with the pitching glove. Because, you know, like, the stitching in the glove right now is navy colored. Let me show you. I mean, yeah, you probably already know this, but... Whoa. Yeah, see, like, the stitching in the glove. It is navy. It almost looks black. With that nice golden, just normal leather color. You can kind of see that it's got a darkish blue navy look to it. And, of course, that's just because, you know, with the Yankees. I mean, if I was with the White Sox, I don't know if I'd make that threading white or black to match their pinstripes. And I mean, there's a good question really quick. The Chicago White Sox primary color. Now, these are retro uniforms. I get that. But would you say their primary color is white or black? Because there's not much white on the Chicago White Sox road uniform. But there's a lot of black on the home and the away uni. So, ooh, watching that sweeper. Just watching it float right the fuck by. Brett Lowry. JT Realmuto. Former Miami Marlin. We've done a couple interview pieces with him on the Marlins Hot Stove Show during the offseason. I think I got his number.
0-1.
Of course, it's at the station in our fucking database, but oh, nice slider just hitting the edge.
No balls, two strikes.
Over the top of that sweeper. Yeah, they're not doing too much better with the with making contact. It just seems like with on rookie run difficulty. It's look Max at this guy's tall Langford as fuck, like a stork.
Aye.
Max Langford. Yeah, it's like Max Ledford. Maximum leg reach. I don't know.
0-2 is the count.
Just a twig. He's not built, but and he misses on the sweeper again. Well, I still might have to do some tweaking with things, because I don't mind winning games and looking pretty good in there, but you know, when I have it on rookie and I get pegged for like 7 or 8 hits and somehow like 3 runs get through, like, come on. You know, just come on. It's like it's on rookie difficulty. Like, am I the rookie or what's the deal?
Designated hitter, Rob Brantley.
That's something I may still need to fuck around with.
I got the count.
Over the top, sweeping curve. Look at that break. I love the movement of these two pitches. And apparently, they don't like it. Well, my legs are still a little sore up from yesterday's workout.
First baseman, Steven Portillo.
Or was that the other day's workout? I don't know, but my legs are still almost knotted up. Oh, fuck. You know what I forgot to do? In between innings here, I have to do a little update on my phone. A little health update. Believe it or not. Like a little pedometer reading. Sweeping curveball. Yeah, we're still getting a lot of strikeouts going here. Not sure what to do with all this. Just not sure.
Left fielder, Daniel.
And you saw where I had the damn sliders. Like, I had that locked in somewhat the same when I was playing MLB The Show 13. Not only did I have it to rookie, you know, pitching difficulty, but those sliders, I had all their shit kind of, well, in the same spot. And to still get tagged along the way, as much as I had been getting tagged, I think I struck all three guys out there. Let me check a little phone thing here. It's like, there's this app on my phone where it can take your heart rate. There's like a pedometer in here somewhere, somehow. More, let me pause counting steps. But let me share this on Instagram. Well, we have 3 hits, but nothing showing for it. Share that on Facebook and on Twitter. late showing, but still late showing, but still showing. Ah, there we go. The work, sorry. Late showing, but still showing the work. Boom. While I was at work today, at the shit job, that was 10,571 steps, approximately 5.3 miles, burned about 450 calories. Not bad. Not bad. That's just based on the walking. That doesn't, you know, incorporate the fact that I'm carrying shit, that I'm pushing and pulling heavy shit around. Maybe a little bit more of a calorie burn than it's saying.
Ball inside.
And still, that was only there for a quick 5 hour cup of coffee, if you will.
Ball, that's outside.
Let's hit the strike zone here. That'd be nice. Right. There we go. Punch to first, but he's got him. Kind of miss Jose Abreu. He was a good little, a good bat, number one.
Now batting, right fielder.
Good fielding Douglas. First baseman.
Tyson.
Barely got that corner. Thought that thing slipped away on us.
0-2.
Topped it. Oh, a good pull down the line, though. Almost looks like I'm wearing ankle braces. These fucking shoes are so black, and they look high tops. You know, look like a nice high top style. Left it hanging, but
he's out.
And I'm not fast enough. Didn't I put my speed up there towards 50 some? Oh no, hey, we got the front guy. That's important to me. Really jammed it up. Okay, I thought that thing was going to get pushed down the first baseline. Oh well. Inning over, I'll take it. End of the fourth here in U.S. Cellular Field. Let's call it Comiskey, who cares? AT&T, no, Candlestick. It will always be Candlestick. See, that's where I'll give credit to the Yankees. Like, they never sold out the fucking name.
JT Realmuto.
Okay, like, I don't know Fenway. Like, I don't know who Fenway is or what it is. I don't know if that's a person, if that was an owner at one point, if that was a company. Like, okay, you got Wrigley Field. Okay, Wrigley, like the chewing gum. Okay. But because the stadium is so old, and Wrigley keeping their name on it, it's like that's before all, you know, everything was a corporate fucking named stadium or a bank, you know? So, like, you kind of have to give Wrigley a pass on that one. It's like they were kind of the first one to do it, I guess. I mean, well, wasn't there a Forbes Field? Sportsman Park. Okay, Sportsman. What, is that like a... Was that like a... the hell am I trying to say? A sporting goods store? Like an outdoors type joint? Sweeping curve? Or was it that this is for a field for sportsmen, you know? Because we'll have anything here. We will have football games here. We'll have baseball games here. We'll have soccer games here. Well, the polo grounds. That was initially built to play polo. They just ended up putting a goddamn diamond in there.
Hey!
Ebbets Field. Was Ebbett a person? Was that also a company? I don't quite know. Sweeping curveball. Perez throwing him out. Like Cleveland Stadium, I said. Milwaukee County Stadium. Atlanta Fulton County Stadium, where the Braves used to play before Turner Field, which is now. Okay, in Turner Field. Turner, me, sure, that is an individual. CNN, fucking, or whatever. I mean, he owns CNN. Well, we got our one run lead, so that's good. Like Comiskey, that was the old owner, I'm pretty sure.
First baseman, Stephen
Candlestick. I don't even know how it got the name Candlestick back in the day, but that was the first one that I recall that started to get, like, the corporate smear put all over the place, because wasn't it, like, 3Com Park, and then it was Monster Park, and, you know, shit like that. Once it all started becoming all those... The only one that I'll give partial credit to is the Astros, because, okay, you went from the Astrodome, and then you had Enron Park, or Enron Field, whatever, and you changed it to Minute Maid. Okay, a fucking orange juice, as opposed to a bank or a financial broker, you know, M&T Bank in Baltimore, Citizens Bank in Philadelphia. Now you got all those goddamn things. There's so many banks and insurance and financial things. Quicken Loans Arena, Wells Fargo Center. There are so many banks and financial bullshit, corporate smear all over these goddamn arenas. It's pathetic. No, was it Bank One, Chase Field in Arizona? Invesco Field at Mile High, which I think they... Sports Authority at... Is it Sports Authority at Invesco Field or Sports Authority at Mile High? I'm not even sure. Because they initially kept the Mile High part of it. Yeah, we're still getting a lot of strikeouts, which is... I don't know if you had to put the sliders all the way down and keep it to rookie difficulty. Like, I don't know where to go right now with all this. This is kind of... This is weird to me. Because I feel that I'm breezing through this game, you know, just the same, even though the sliders are up at perfect mid. You would think they're going to be making more contact, better contact, solid contact.
Ball one. One ball, one
where strike. I had those sliders down low for their contact and their power and all that shit, like, I don't know.
I got to count one and two.
I mean, this looks like a spring training game where guys are just trying to make contact on pitches. Well, that one went ole right through me.
No, he's safe.
Great fucking effort, though. I mean, you can't play that thing any better than he just did. He got the glove on it, and then the roll and the turn. Just by a whisper, he missed him. You're gonna pull me, you fucking hack. Okay, best of luck to you. Ken Giles, don't fuck this up. You let by a hit. That earned run's gonna go against... Oh, and then you walk him. Oh, and then look at that. Oh, no, a force out. So that one. Nope. Oh, I'll be damned you got out of that. I will be damned. Where did he pull me in the seventh here? Where was that? Thank God we got the insurance run. Does the win go to me, though? These are things I need to know. He gave me the fucking hook way early. Was that in the seventh? Three hits, I think that was. Oh, baby Jesus Chapman. Wow. I don't even know how that's considered a save. You're up 3-0, he lets by two runs. Okay, how bad was the damages here? 12 strikeouts in 6 innings? Because that's not as intense as I thought it was going to. That's still really good. I mean, if he would have given me 7 innings, would I've gotten 14? 8 innings, would I've gotten, you know what I mean? 2 per? Yeah, I don't know, man. Well, there's our 12th win of the year. Yeah, I let by 2 hits. No walk. I let by 2 hits. What, am I hurt or what's the deal here? Why did I get pulled like that? The Braves trade first baseman Robbie Hobson to the Yankees for shortstop Vaughn Parker. Well, we got the win. This 3-game set at U.S. Cellular. We win the series, but Chris Sale serves us a loss. 8-0, we couldn't hit the motherfucker. Wow. Simulated game training, skip it. Speaking of that stuff... Okay, now it's in the red. Uh-oh. hasn't dropped yet. Yeah, I put my speed up to 50. I thought I did that. Oh, well, calendar. 3-game set against Boston. I get the third game, so if anything, we will be holding on to, not getting swept. Because we lose the first game. We lose the second game, and it's up to me to not get us swept by the Red Sox. However, let me save. Because you know I got my little idea. If this is my 3-game minimum just to get things, you know. This will be my last game that I play of the evening because I got to work early tomorrow. Well, I got to be up early and take care of some things. But interactions, oh, we don't have the trade interactions. Son of a bitch. Maybe after this game we'll see what that looks like. Anyway, Metzger versus Owens, we are home. Red Sox, Yankees. 2.5 games back. See, had we gotten one of these other games against Boston, I just don't like the fact the Orioles are ranked 19th. They have a 2.5 game lead on us, who are ranked 2nd in all of baseball. To me, that's just... this team's underachieving. It's fucking horrendous. And, no, sir, I don't like it. So, let's get this one going. What is this? Caught stealing? That's the fewest, I would hope. Well, yeah, we don't have anybody who tries to steal. So that's kind of easy. We've been caught stealing 14 times. You know, we're the Yankees. Other than when Ricky Henderson was there. How often were the Yankees trying to swipe bases? That's just really weird. It's kind of like the Blue Jays nowadays, you know? It's like, they got all those power hitters. Why do they need to fucking steal bases? Certain teams rely on that. Socha's Angels, you know, would play that small ball stuff and do all those things. Is it Ned Yost with Kansas City? They'd be playing that same brand of small ball. All right, we have 2 fewer losses than them, if I saw that correctly. Why is my stream locked up here? I hate that. Bogarts, Ricky Jordan, Mookie Betts. They got some decent batting average. Rusny Castillo, Jackie Bradley Jr. Pablo Sandoval is batting .274, and he's the last guy in the lineup. They got some mean bats here in Boston. Yeah, the dynamic difficulty, I don't know where I need to sit with all this stuff. It's really weird for me right now.
One ball, no strike.
First pitch, 107.
Punching it, foul. That'll be his first strike. Oh. Thank God he went for it. Way outside. And I didn't miss the mark by that much. Damn it. Nothing. Perfect timing. Still slapped her pretty good. 54 speed. I don't think he'll be stealing. At least I hope not.
Exactly.
Looking over to my phone. I do need to get some shit taken care of, actually, now that I think about it.
0-1.
Check that swing on a power check. That was woof. Oh.
0-2.
Okay, I don't know what he was fishing on for that one. That one stayed gripped up a little bit and got him for the sweeping curveball strikeout. Get him the fuck out. Get him the fuck out of here. 8th in the American League with a .307 average. Not bad. Not bad at all.
That's a strike. No ball.
Yeah, it looks like they're watching that first pitch go by.
No ball.
Down in the dirt. Don't know what that was all for. Almost looked like it was on pace there to fucking hit its mark. It did not. Oh, that was one, wasn't it?
Yep.
Why didn't you step on first and then make the throw? Oh, for fuck's sakes. I thought he did. Can I challenge that? I mean, that's just a programming flaw. Why would he not do that, San Diego Studios? Please tell me. I mean, his it's the length of his foot. If he just stands up, turns, makes a slight step. I mean, sure, we got the lead runner. Okay, fine, but that was too fucking clean to get a double play, and just nope.
Yeehaw!
No, sir, I don't like it.
0-1.
Just straight up damn, yo. Go fishing. Come on, guy. Not when I leave it in the zone like that.
No, that's down.
Perfect timing. Kisses the edge. He doesn't go for it. God fucking damn it. I hate this camera angle.
Batting fifth. Second baseman. Jed Jerko.
Yeah, help me out here, would you?
Ow!
Am I hurt? What happened here? Nothing? I mean, it hit me. Look at that, they got two hits. One was the camera angle. That other one could have been an easily picked up double play. Oh, well. Dribbler, strikeout. Okay, back to the mound. 18 pitches in that first inning? That's fucking terrible.
Catcher.
That's all he said. Got under that one nicely. But not far enough. Good snag out there, Mr. Shades. They do have some good batting averages on this team, though. So I wonder if Boston's pitching is just their weak point. Of course, then again, it's early in the year. Maybe some of these batting averages are a bit... Woody Keller, I don't think I like him. I don't like many of the umpires.
0-2.
I just got to strike motherfuckers out, because even when I had the fucking... the pitcher's umpire perk, like, lit up for myself, yeah, it wasn't doing anything. I'm surprised he even went for that pitch. Wrong thing.
My time.
You want the sinker low, and I respect that. I just picked the wrong thing.
Ha! Three.
Watching the screwball. Oh, shit, yeah. Works for me.
Batting eight, the left fielder number 25, Jackie Bradley Jr.
Yeah. No ball. Two strikes.
Outside on the screwy. All right, let me phone it up here. What's this? Oh, with all the fun happenings. You know, I live in the greater Miami area, just north of that, in Fort Lauderdale. And, of course, Dwayne Wade left the Miami Heat to go back home, right, to the Chicago Bulls. So this, I'm actually getting some love from this on Facebook as I write. Heat fans are idiots. LeBron, a free agent, leaves and he's not loyal. Wade, who Miami drafted, leaves and thanks for the memories, we wish you all the best. But you know who's been the most loyal to the Miami Heat? Udonis Haslam and Eric Spoelstra. And Heat fans are rolling their eyes wondering when Miami is finally going to get rid of all that dead weight. I'm surprised there are people that, you know, would consider themselves Heat fans who absolutely agree with that and say, dude, you're right. The dummies down here don't even hear their own hypocrisy.
Leading off for Boston.
It's like, yeah, everybody wants greatness. Pablo. Why did every, like, there was this thing that happened down here, this little hashtag of don't hate Miami, and I only remember seeing that as soon as LeBron got down here.
0-2.
It stayed even after LeBron left, but, you know, that's when even the Heat were starting to hate. Like, oh, what a fucking pussy. LeBron's going home. He's never going to win jack shit. That motherfucker's going to Cleveland. Fuck that guy. Fuck that guy. Yeah, whatever. 90% of Floridians are not from Florida, by the way. They're a bunch of fucking, you know, New York Puerto Ricans or New York Ricans, right? Cubans. Jewish people from New York. All from the boroughs. Like no one from Florida is really, like, from Florida. If they're, like, a redneck, yeah. Because Florida is a southern state. Country music is a big deal down here. Now, granted, South Florida is a little different than North Florida, for sure. Oh, that was a slider, excuse me. I mean, North Florida is definitely redneck and southern. South Florida, like, further past Orlando south, that's when it really starts to become the melding pot that everybody says. But Florida in general is a southern state. So it's very, you know, it's warm, it's outdoorsy, it's, you know, redneck, swamp, heat, all that shit. Miami is like the only true area. Well, the Keys is different in its own right. But that's why it's the Keys and not, you know, part of Florida, essentially. They want to be their own fucking, what, the Conch Republic? But South Florida being the melting pot, yeah, it's like all the New York Ricans come down here from New York.
1-0.
And they love Puerto Rico even though they're here and in New York.
Uh-huh.
And they love New York even though they're always down here. But if the Yankees are winning, they love
the
Yankees. If the Heat are winning, they love the Heat. They'll like the Knicks if they're winning. They're never consistent, I guess. They're so screwed up in their own ways, they don't see their own hypocrisies. Slider. But, yeah, so there's even, like, Heat fans that are agreeing with my little blurb on Facebook. They're like, I like that. A little bit of thumbs up. Okay. And keep in mind, I'm the Chicago guy. I don't like the move Dwayne Wade to the Bulls. 6 years ago, I would have liked it. But now, at this age, at that price, no, that's a nostalgia. That's a dumb pickup for the Bulls. That really is. That's a desperation move on their part, and I don't even know why. They got rid of Noah and Rose, which Joakim Noah leaving is going to hurt them more than Derrick Rose leaving. Because Derrick Rose can probably get hurt again, and you'll never miss him if he's hurt. You won't miss him if he's hurt. And he'll get hurt. Joakim Noah gets hurt. You don't make the playoffs, Chicago Bulls. That's exactly what happened. Derrick Rose would get hurt. They would still get to the playoffs. Sinker. Nice. So, Joakim Noah leaving the Bulls hurts more than Derrick Rose leaving. Proof in the pudding. Rose would get hurt. They would still make the playoffs. Noah gets hurt. They don't make the playoffs. Simple. So Dwayne Wade, he'll miss about 20 to 30 games, whether it's just, you know, got to let the batteries recharge or watch him get hurt. And I know he's going back home. He's from Chicago. He went to Marquette nearby university. And it's not, you know, it's not a big joint. It's not, what would be good down that way? Illinois, I mean, screwball. It's not a huge basketball school. I mean, yeah, you got, what was that, God. He was good with Utah for a cup of coffee. Well, not a cup of coffee. Is it Darren Williams? Is that the guy I'm thinking of? The point guard that drove out the old coach, Jerry Sloan. That's the point guard I'm thinking of, right? Darren Williams, D-E-R-O-N, Daron, Darren Williams. Then he went to Brooklyn, I think it was. That guy. As soon as he left Utah, his game went to shit. I mean, I had him and Chris Paul as, like, the top two point guards full game. Offense, defense, distribution. I had those two as top point guards in the league. Back in, you know, when Williams was with Utah. But as soon as he got Jerry Sloan fired and then left him his damn self, no respect for that little fuck. None. Ain't nobody got time for that. Know what I'm saying? Anyway. Phone, come on. Let's work with me here. Because I don't know what else is going on right now. I don't need all that crap jumbling up the emails. Anyway.
Leading off for Boston, right fielder.
Beautiful blue sky. See, I love... This is how baseball should be. There are not clouds in this sky right now. Watch this again. One pitch out, by the way. And I fielded it well.
Jackie Bradley Jr.
Fifth inning, 55 pitches. All right, screwball down and in. Look at that sky. God damn, that's beautiful. That is summertime. Oof. Now, granted, in the game, this is what? This is somewhere early to mid-June. And in real life, well, this is 2020. Me playing this is July 7th of 2016 on a Thursday, in case you're wondering. But, oh, the summertime weather. That clear sky, get out there to the beach. Of course, I live right by the Atlantic Ocean. Close enough, maybe a mile away. Screwball, looking at it. Yeah, I still need to make some adjustments with, what if I drop the sliders all the way down and put it back up to rookie?
No ball.
Because, you know, the guys that were just popping the home runs off of me, I mean, it made no sense based on my ability and where things were.
Out.
You know, rookie difficulty with the sliders and everything and my ability and all that shit. It really made no sense. At least to me, it made no sense. I don't know about that dude getting down like that. He looking real crazy, you know? Oh, shit. We got our one-run cushion, so that's good. Get those out of the way. 86% charge. Base is loaded, and you strike out. I saw that. Was that Perez? You know, if my stream wasn't buffering, I'd be able to tell you.
Xander Bogaerts.
Ball. No, that's it.
There's a shot.
Just foul.
You know what else I'm going to do? I'm going to give a chat text test. Boonk. And boonk. It shows. Okay. Just making sure.
Two.
In there for the strike. Come on. Was that a strikeout? Because I know I threw a screwball to him. Nope, one and two count. That was in there. We'll see where the strikeouts are today, and then we'll kind of decipher
designated hitter,
where
Ricky
we should go.
Ha!
Ha! Screwball there.
Oh,
perfect timing. And it just didn't hit the target. Which I don't get that. When you have, like, perfect control. Like, I have, what, 90, even on the low end. 90 control on, I think, damn near all my pitches except the, swooping curve. Except on the sinker. I have 90 control on everything. And still, the ball will fly all over the place and not hit any part of the size of that glove. It's like, I miss MVP Baseball 2005. I really do. If EA came back with that, it was, maybe some upgradable tweaks and whatnot, I'm not saying it would give the show a run for its money, but I think it could really damage the show's sales. If EA Sports wanted to pick up baseball again... Dude, okay, EA Sports, you don't fucking need NBA Live. That shit hasn't been good since it came out in the mid-90s. You don't need it anymore. 2K is taking the hoops game and it's gone. You're doing good with NHL, I feel. Not that there's any competition for it. You know, Madden, you need to rethink the fucking... You need to stop with Madden, because those games ain't been good for a decade. The Madden games have not been good since, you know, the new-gen shit. PS2, no problem. Sweeping curve. Madden was good on the PS2. That was at its best. Specifically, Madden 03, 04, and 05. Those in consecutive years, probably the best Madden games altogether. Then, well, we're putting it on a new-gen console, so let's make this vision cone thing. Too much. And then you fuck up the button combination, the configuration. It used to be square, X, and circle. Because, you know, that lines up horizontally on the controller to some degree, right? Now it's like, no, to pick your plays into... Now it'll be triangle, square, and X. Well, that's a vertical line. That doesn't make any sense. I mean, I tried going in to play that, and plus the controls fucked, the physics are fucked. I don't know what pitch that was, but I'll bet you it was fucked. I'm gonna guess it was a sweeping curveball. But EA Sports, if you stopped with Madden, and if you stopped with NBA Live, and try to pick up baseball again, bring back MVP, stay on NHL, that's fine. Seems to be doing well. FIFA seems to be doing okay, despite their own scandals.
He's out.
You don't have an NCAA football game, so you can probably put a little bit more time for those things. I almost wouldn't worry about a fucking NCAA hoops game, because who gives a shit about the NCAA hoops anything? You don't want Cinderella stories. You want Duke and North Carolina and, you know, like a Georgetown, a UCLA, Kentucky, Kansas. You want all those traditional teams to go. You don't want George Mason versus Butler in the fucking finals. You don't. Boston, you right don't. That's poison. What if Butler beat Duke that one year? It would have proven an absolute point that the one and done should not happen. If the NBA wants to draft the kids straight out of high school, they should. Keeping kids one and done, no, what that would totally change the game of college hoops. And I'm not even sure if that would be for the better.
That's a ball.
But you wouldn't have fifth-year seniors at Butler and George Mason and fucking Florida. That was a heavy slider that he reached for. Heavy. 8 complete games going for 9.
Jackie Bradley Jr.
But EA Sports could really just, if you brought back MVP baseball to give the show a run for its money, maybe you can do a little bit of damage along the way. Because I felt there were parts of that that were far more crisp. Sweeping curveball. Now we're just mowing people down here again. Disgusting-like. Very disgusting-like. In the 8th, 87 pitches on. God damn it.
1-1.
I was hoping it was going to be a 3-pitch out. Still could be.
No. 2-1.
But not anymore.
2-2.
Thankfully, he whiffed on that one. Getting bad luck. No luck. Everything outside, I'm not fucking hitting the zone, so let's not try to do that, okay? And this son of a bitch is going to, like, check fucking pop foul everything. Screwball and that thing drop like a motherfucker. So, do we make it to the 9th or does... Well, it's 1-0. If he brings in Chapman, I wouldn't be surprised. I would just say, look at what I've been doing for you. Keeping me in 94 pitches. My energy is still above half.
Leading off for Boston.
Like, I could probably go fucking 17 innings the way it's going. Not that I want to give up one run to fucking prove that point. And keep in mind, Yankees, I'm trying to get traded. I keep asking. Xander is out.
Out.
A little scratch here, excuse me.
Designated hitter, Ricky Jordan.
Ricky Jordan. Wasn't that a fucking, Well, there was Ricky Jackson was a linebacker in the NFL. Wasn't there a Ricky Jordan? Who am I thinking of? He was an Atlanta Brave, I want to say early 90s. Oh, broke his bat. I don't do that often. But that slider inside, yeah. I think I've done that once before. I think I've splintered some lumber early. I think it was in spring training. No, the beanball somebody. That for damn sure. It was during spring training. That may have been the first broken bat of my pitching career. Might have been. I could be wrong there. But hey, the game's over. I wasn't even paying attention to how that was working because I was so worried about the broken bat. Game done. And another 17 strikeout. That's a lot. Three hits, you know. I got to find some happy medium here. Because I can't be letting by three runs a fucking game on rookie difficulty. It doesn't make any sense like that. I got to find some happy medium. Didn't strike out anybody in the ninth. No, it was a six-pitch inning, but, you know. Four shutouts in a season, getting the shutout, complete game, quality start, win. Yay. Calendar. So, I saved the three-game series against Boston. My next scheduled game with the Yankees is going to be game two of a four-game set against Cleveland. See what we do. Severino against Texas, loss. Mueller, win. Eovaldi, win. Okay, so two out of three against Texas. Cleveland, Cortez, start us off. Loss. Okay, I would be facing Trevor Bauer, but a couple of things that I want to do. Just with, hold on. Sliders. No, hold on. Okay. Pitching difficulty, I'm going to go to rookie. Excuse me, back to rookie. Apply changes, but sliders I'm going to modify. Like, I don't know where I had their stuff. Contact, power, timing, I don't know where it was. Foul frequency, shift the slider to the right to increase fouls on borderline swings and hits. That'll land just fair. More fouls will get betters, no more deep counts, but also protects them on two strikes. So keep that middle. Solid hits. Alright, then there's starters and all that shit. Manager, okay. Yeah, I mean, it might be cheap, but I mean, can't you say the game was being cheap as well? Save these settings. And save the game because, well, no, I got, you know, other stuff to worry about here. But and we are, whoops. On rookie with those lowered sliders. So, let's give her a save here. And we're going to give it the 3-trade minimum, I guess. A 3-game minimum, a 3-trade request minimum. So, just before this game, let's go interactions, and it's there. Trade request. Couldn't find any potential. I don't believe you. Load. That was one. Two more attempts. Let's see if they're able to appease us here. Interactions, trade. Still haven't found a deal that benefits both sides. I think you're lying. Last try coming up right now. Let's see what we can do because, I mean, if you look at the calendar, we ain't got much time left for this to happen. Trade request, last try for this recording. As soon as we find a deal, we'll pull the trigger. God damn it. Well, yeah, look at the calendar here. Let's see, it's the 23rd. We got about a month and a week, 5 weeks in a day, technically. It's getting close, and I've been requesting a trade pretty goddamn frequently. So, because our interactions are done, well, let's save it just so we know it's locked in, and I don't try to redo it and fire it up you know, next time I play the live stream Let's Play of MLB The Show 16 here on the PS4, right? Oh, boy. Well, next up we play Cleveland. Wait, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1. On the road against Houston. Houston is, never mind. I was picturing, oh shit, I hate that one, that, how sensitive that damn thing is. Yeah, go to them, okay, anyway. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We would be facing Eric Gomez in Houston in Minute Maid. And then, hold on, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1. 2, 3, 4, 5, 1. Then we would be hosting Oakland. And then working our way towards the All-Star game. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1. Then we would be hosting Toronto. Next recording, I mean, we'll see. No guarantees if it's going to be a 4-game. The 3-game minimum, we would get through the Oakland game. At the very least. As we approach the All-Star game. And then beyond that, approaching the trade deadline. Oh my god, it's killing me. It's killing me. Well, I remember last episode when I was looking at my career numbers. I'm going to do that off camera just for my own personal mental masturbation as far as what innings pitched and strikeouts and all that shit. Just to keep tabs for myself for whatever reason. But the numbers are looking pretty hectic right now, I do admit. Yeah, looking like an MVP going for 4 in a row here. Looking like a Cy Young, going to be 4 in a row here. Jesus. J.D. Martinez, Mr. Batting Title, which... he didn't get the MVP that year because I stole it from him in 2017. It's true. Just ask him. Reliever. Oh, Oakland's got two guys going for Rookie of the Year. Hank Aaron, Gold Glover ain't going to be me. Yeah, do we have anything? Okay, yeah, Perez on the Gold Glove there. Montero at first. And this is going towards the All-Star game. Friedrich. Shortstop, no. Outfielder, no. Herrera in center. Fair. Silver Slugger, LeMahieu's a DH. That's odd. Huh. Perez as catcher. Silver Slugger, now we're talking here. Just looking over a couple of things. Nope. Oh, well. Still looking like we're tops there. Oh, All-Star voting, sorry. Yeah, we're killing it with 740,000 votes. That's a lot. That's a lot. Well, with all that, I'm going to check the career numbers. Wait, not... there we go. I want to check the career numbers of Derek Metzger once I get all this shit checked out. But, oh, well, there's one thing I wanted to show you from how things are going. How many home runs did I allow last year? Jesus. Okay, rookie year. Let by 12 as a rookie. In 2017, combination Baltimore and New York, 12 home runs. In 2018, I only allowed 9 home runs. Last year, for whatever reason, I allowed 16 home runs. That's not right. That's really not. And so far this year, I've already allowed 10. So even on that rookie difficulty, like, I don't know where to find tweak, where to fine tune all these things. It just, it's really weird to me how I can let by. Now, the earned runs... you know, okay, from 34 in that dual year. Solo year in with the Yankees, 2018, 30. Then it goes to 32. Okay, 16 now, and that's probably going to dip because I've had it on dynamic. But I went back to rookie with a couple of those sliders all the way down. I'm going to see how that goes for maybe 3 games worth or however the case is. But just the home runs alone from 9 to 16? 2018 was a really good year for me, I feel. And... from 9 home runs to 16 allowed. Something about that is... I hit more batsmen. Maybe that was on purpose, though. Can't say that. Don't know. Okay, wild pitches. 5 there, 0 with 16 allowed. I don't know how that's... well, Mike, you allowed fewer hits. Well, look at that! In 2018, I allowed way more hits and few more home runs than I did in 2019. I allowed fewer hits, more fucking home runs. That really makes no sense to me. That means that they're really teeing off, and I don't know where the happy medium is for what I'm trying to do with the sliders and the difficulty and all that shit. So that's why I'm fucking around with it right now. I started the dynamic stuff within this 2020 season. Been toying with that. I kept it on dynamic, which it's still very low on the scale. But I brought sliders up to, like, you know, perfect midway for this previous game. Nothing good there. So I go back to rookie pitching difficulty, put a couple of those sliders all the way down to the floor. We'll see how things go. I'm still trying to find that happy medium. Like, 2018, like I said, was a great year. Only allowing 9 home runs, which, okay, that's basically one a month. I mean, what, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, 7, okay, just over one a month, and then 16. How did that number jump so incredibly high, even though I allowed fewer hits? You know, do they show, like, faced batsmen or something like that? You would think they do. Innings pitch was about the same. Yeah, I did have more strikeouts. But the ERA, slight jump, it's not terrible. Look at the ERA this year. And I've really been killing it the past few games with the dynamic difficulty. Total batters faced, is that the thing? 980 to 9... Well, yeah, 980 to 950. Okay, well, the war was better. K per 9 wasn't. Walks was fewer. Home runs, you know, close to half. Jesus. I don't understand it. And I know these numbers are ridiculous. It's like, Mike, why are you crying about this? Well, if things would have stayed on the 2018 pace, maybe I'm not complaining so much. Because the rookie year, I understand. I was a rookie. 2017, I could see how the numbers kind of do a little shift because you go from Baltimore to the Yankees, so the back half of the season was really good for you. 2018 was beautiful, and we won the World Series. 2019, I'm letting by a lot of home runs all of a sudden. Like, damn near double the previous year, and I don't know, it just seemed really weird to me. But yet I allowed fewer just overall hits. I don't know. That just seems really odd to me. So, and even this year, now, I have allowed 10 home runs. I've allowed more home runs this year than I did all of 2018, and I've only been, what do we got, innings pitch? 115 innings pitched as opposed to 276. Something's just odd with that whole thing, don't you think? I don't know. It just seems really weird to me, but I'm going to look over these career numbers and, you know, check where I'm at on all-time leader lists just for my, like I said, my own mental masturbation, but yeah, I think too much about these things. I get way too analytical with it. Anal and analytical. Well, whatever. Swig of organic green tea for the gamer guys and gals out there real quick before we close out. Ah, it's so good. Prince of Peace organic green tea. Look for it in your local Whole Foods if you have one nearby. Anyway, if it's a 3-game minimum coming up, 3 to 4, I'm going to guess, because that'll get us right to the All-Star game, which I'm going to be in, by the way. But that's how we're looking for now. As for now, MJ signing out for now. Till we meet again, everybody. And, well, whether it's in Cleveland or in Houston or in Toronto, well, we'll be hosting some of those teams. Either way, whether it's on the mound, in the batter's box, the on-deck circle, on the base path, in the bullpen, or at the All-Star game. Don't know where, but I guarantee I will catch your ass down the road.